Hello, and welcome to ShipU Stats. In this video, we're going to go over different variable types in JASP. In JASP, you'll notice that across the top where you have these different variable names, that there's an interesting little symbol next to each of them. These symbols will denote whether or not you have a nominal, ordinal, or scale variable. And if you click on it, you'll see all of those different options. Here, you can change those variables accordingly to best match the data that you have in your dataset. It's important to select the correct type of variable that you have so that you can run the right statistical tests in JASP. JASP will only run the statistical tests that you're asking for if you have a variable type selected that works for that particular statistical test. Let's go ahead and take a look at how we can determine whether or not we have the right variable type selected. Let's go to descriptive statistics. If we go to descriptive statistics and we go down to split here, you'll notice that we have a nominal as well as an ordinal variable type selected here. That means that we can only use ordinal and nominal variables in this particular section. You'll also notice that over here it says nominal and ordinal variables. What that means is that if we want a frequency table, it will only provide them for nominal or ordinal variables. Let's go ahead and take a look at t-tests. In a t-test here, you'll notice that scale variables are the only variable that will work here. And again, nominal and ordinal variables will work there. JASP makes it very easy to identify what type of variable you need for each of these individual tests. Thanks for watching this short video on variable types.